Are you struggling in the edit? Are your edits all jittery and you're having trouble with playback and your computer just can't keep up with your footage? Well, today I'm going to share with you a very simple and what's better, free solution that just might change your editing workflow. 4K, 6K, 8K, 12K RAW. I mean, the resolution race is definitely on, and in a lot of respects, that's really good. There's so many benefits to having access to higher resolution footage, but it also comes with a number of unique drawbacks. And editing all that shiny new footage is the biggest one. The computing power needed to edit all of these files natively is really grunty and frankly, very, very expensive. Thankfully, there is a super simple solution that is not only free, but it's built into most modern editing systems. And that is proxies. Beautiful, glorious proxies. Now, what is a proxy? Well, a proxy is basically a low resolution copy of your raw media that is optimized for your editing suite. So what will happen is your editing suite will take your native media file and it will swap it for this small proxy file while you're working on your project. This will make the editing and playback process buttery smooth. And frankly, it's the only way that we've managed to get through some of our larger projects. Not only this, but it will save you a ton of cash in upgrading your computer to keep up with this resolution race that seems to be changing every year. Today, I'm going to show you how to generate and use proxies in both Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve. And the time codes to each of those will be down in the description. All right, let's get into it. All right, guys, to start off with, we're here in Adobe Premiere Pro. So we've got this edit going on and it's not playing back the smoothest. So what I wanna do is I wanna generate some proxy files for this edit. So if I go down here, I've got a folder with some media in it and this is all full resolution media. Now, if I wanna create proxies, what I do is you can either do this clip by clip or you can just click on the entire folder, right click, proxy, create proxies. And then you'll have a pop-up window that will appear and you've got a couple of options. Now I'm gonna stick with QuickTime and ProRes low resolution proxy because I'm on a Mac. If you're on a PC, these may be slightly different options. You might want to choose something like DNxHR. I'm going to stick with ProRes. And then you've got two other options. Now you can either get Premiere Pro to create a proxy folder next to wherever you're storing all your original media, which is what we like to do, or you can select your own custom folder to house that media. I'm going to put it in the default location. And then I'm gonna hit okay. And the great thing is once you're finished with your project, if you need to free up some hard drive space, you can just find that proxy folder, delete it, and it won't impact your edit at all. So now that that's done, if we go down to Media Encoder, you'll see that it's created a list and it's already started generating proxies for us. So go have a cup of tea. If you've got quite a bit of media, this might take quite a bit of time to process. I like to do my proxy runs overnight for this reason, but this one shouldn't take too long. All right, all our proxies are now complete. So let's jump back into Premiere Pro and let's go back down to our project window. Now, I want to make sure that these proxies have actually linked up properly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click in this gray area here. I'm going to select metadata display and then I'm going to type in proxy. And we're gonna make sure that that is checked, hit okay. And then if you scroll across here, let's just open that up a bit. Scroll across here, right over to the right-hand side, you'll see a proxy column is present. And it confirms that yes, there are proxies that are attached to all of this media. So the next thing I wanna do is how do you turn on and off proxies to get the most benefit out of them? So what I wanna do here is I'm gonna go to this section of your program window. And what you wanna do is you wanna go over to the plus button and you wanna find this icon here, which is our toggle proxies icon, and click and drag that down into our list. And now when you toggle that on, as you can see, let's open this up a bit, that has gone to a low resolution version of the media. So what this does is it, when you click this button on, it's referencing the proxies. When you click it again, it's referencing the raw media. So when you've got proxies turned on, it'll make the editing so much smoother. So you can be doing your edit, be working through it with the proxies on, and then say you need to check something, like you're doing a grade or something like that, and you need to make sure that everything is looking the way it should, you need to see it in full resolution, just hit that button again, boom, you can see all your full resolution media. And that's really, really handy. And the great thing about that is that when you go to export your project, it doesn't matter whether this is on or off, it will completely ignore the proxies. It will just reference your original media. So you don't need to worry about it spitting out something with low resolution media, it won't happen. So that's how you generate and use proxies in Adobe Premiere Pro. All right, guys, so now we've jumped over to DaVinci Resolve. And as you can see, we've got a lot of B-Raw raw media here. So let's create some proxies. So first things, if we want to set up our proxy settings, we go to File, Project Settings. And then here in our master settings, we have this section here, which is Optimized Media and Render Cache. So you can let DaVinci Resolve decide automatically what it wants to set its proxies too, does a pretty good job of that, but you might end up with some pretty grunty sized files, particularly if they're doing ProRes 422 HQ. So what I like to do is I like to use ProRes 422 proxy. It's small, doesn't take up a lot of space, and the rest we can leave as is, and then hit save. Now what we want to do is we want to select what media we want to create optimized media for. So what you would do is Command A, select all of your media. I'm not going to do that today. I'm just going to select a few clips, or we'll be here all day. And then I'm going to go right click and then generate optimized media. Click that button and a pop-up will remain. And then as you see, a pop-up will appear and it started to encode that media for you. So go have a cup of tea. And when you come back, it should be ready. Now, depending on the size of your project, this might take quite a lot of time, so this might be something that's worth running overnight. And we're back. So as you can see, that is just about to complete. And there we go, all of our optimized media has been generated. Now what you can do, if you want to toggle it off and on, what you do is you go up to the playback, and then you can go use optimized media if available. So you can just select that on or off. And if that's selected on, then you'll be using your proxies and that should help smooth out that edit beautifully. And then if you want to turn it off, you want to check out your full resolution media, select that again. And the great thing is once you're done with the project and you've bounced it out, you've exported it and it's been delivered. And again, if you want to free up some hard drive space, right inside of DaVinci Resolve, you can just hit delete optimized media and it will erase all of those proxies for you. So it's really, really easy to use. All right, now let's go over to the deliver tab because I want to show you something interesting. So here in our deliver tab, if we go over to our advanced settings, you can see that it will not, like Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve will not use those proxy files unless you ask it to. So there's actually a checkbox here that if you select that, it will export using your optimized media, using your proxy files. I don't know why you would want to do that, but it's good to know that you can check if it's exporting proxies. So by default, that checkbox will always be turned off. So that's really, really good. So there you have it, guys. That's how you create and use proxies in DaVinci Resolve. Well, there you have it, guys. I hope this video has saved you a little bit of time and a lot of stress when editing your videos. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know down in the comments below. While you're down there, let me know if you'd like to see more little editing tips and tricks and tutorials just like this one. If you got value out of this video, please consider subscribing so that you can see more videos just like this every single week. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you in the next video.